Hey guys, so I am back. What I decided to cook was some gumbo and make some macaroni and cheese. Now, can y'all see I have my pot on high and you see how it's not boiling over? That wooden spoon is keeping it from boiling over. Now, you know, I saw that online and I thought I would try it. See if it actually works, and it does work. But I'm going to turn my noodles down because I don't need them to burn. So I got my pot on low. I'm going to cut up a little bit of onion. Little bit. Take part of that onion off, and sometimes that bad boy gets slippery. You have to watch your fingers. So, I have some gumbo mix. By this company that I love their seasoning, Louisiana, and this is the seasoning, well, not this particular, but the brand of seasoning that I use for my boiling my crabs or making my goody pot, as I call it. My goody pot consists of like smoked meat, like smoked neck bone, sausage and shrimp, potatoes, that kind of stuff, and not adding the crab. It could even just be, you know, I smoke neck bones and potatoes. It could be just sausage and neck bones, you know, just a little goody pot. You know, you kind of want that little seafood flavor, you need a little spice, a little kick or something. That's what I use. So I'm using this. And I'm going to put a little oil in it. Just a flash. To get that going. Noodles. I'm using penne pasta. I'm gonna make some macaroni and cheese really quick. My oven is already heated. I think sometime this week I'm gonna make a chicken casserole. So I'm gonna have to use my Velveeta cheese tonight because I have to save my other cheese for my casserole. Big box. This is the big box. Now, if they sell one bigger than this, y'all, I need to find out because I have grown to love Velveeta cheese. Now, I'm not going to use this whole thing now. I'm talking about if you stop that. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to get that.
I'm going to get me a little salt pan.
Wash it out. Turn it on. Now,
what in the world?
Now I want to talk to y'all really quick while that's heating up about my find. Now, I love baking, but I don't do it often because I'm trying to lose some weight. I'm going to try to lose some weight. I'm trying not to give in to my temptations all the time. But the only type of butter that I grew up on and that I truly, truly love, and I'm not paid to say this, I'm just telling y'all, like, it is for me, okay? It's Land O'Lakes butter, okay? Now, this is a two-pack, and these are, it's 2 pounds, and I got the salted, okay? Mm-hmm. They have unsalted and salted. I got 2-pack. Now, I can remember paying almost $9 for this butter at one point. I can remember paying $6.98. I can even remember paying almost $8 for this butter. When I tell you this was $4.98 in Walmart, yeah, $4.98. The single one is $3 and some change by itself. This was $4.98 by itself. You best believe I got 2, okay? Mm-hmm. Talk to y'all real quick about this. I get this from the deli. This is the mesquite turkey, and it is $6.48 a pound. Y'all, this is so good. I just eat it with a spicy pickle. I don't even have to have bread. The other night I did make me a sandwich with this, and instead of using lettuce, I used spinach leaves. We talking about what's good. And I took the skin off the cucumber and sliced them up. And I sliced up a pickle on top of it. And I used the pickle juice to be my dressing for my cucumber. That was my dinner. You talking about was good. It was showing up good, but guess what? I didn't get full. I didn't. My husband, he fried him a slice of ham. But you know, we had a half a ham that we had the deli to slice and steak for us. Hold on. Oh, excuse me. We had a ham that we got the deli to slice and steak for us. And he had 2 slices. And I was looking at it, I was like, baby, will you please cook me a piece of that? He came back and cooked me a piece. Y'all, it was so good. And he put a little black pepper and a little spice on it. I don't know what kind of seasoning he put on, but it was good. So I got to give me another knife because I can't get onion on my butter. Let me move this. I am just truly hurting myself today. Got water on that. Yeah, working it out. A little bit of milk in here. I stick above. This is my cheese, and I think I'm going to use triple cheddar. I'm going to save this for the top. This and some of that Velveeta for my casserole. Not even half the bag.
that melt slowly.
Those are ready. Drain those in the sink. Okay.
Okay. This is for my chicken.
I'm gonna leave this on low
until I get ready to use it.
And it's gonna be heating up.
Got my dish for my macaroni and cheese. I'm gonna cut up my sausage. Do three sausage.
Do a little bit of this. Let me rinse my sausage off. Thank you.
going, y'all. Now, they have this label on here. It's labeled in 4 ounces. So I am going to use about 8 ounces. I keep pulling the skirt down. I don't want to take pictures. That's going to take a few minutes to pull. So while that's doing that,
Dishes really quick while that's cooking. Get them out of the way so I get my macaroni and cheese in the oven. That way I can start my chicken. Now, I almost forgot my potatoes, though. They are done, crisp and brown. I'm going to go up a little bit. Preheat it to 400. Thank you. Y'all, when I tell y'all I feel so much better, my head is free. Oh my God. I don't have on a wig. I was wearing wigs because my hair was nasty. And I was trying to let it grow out. Didn't want to relax it. But now I don't have to do that. I'm going to give my head a chance to breathe. Like stuff in my elbows. Make sure I don't knock open my lip. A little bit of salt. Cut my butter up in here while it's in the pot. Three tablespoons of butter. Get my rag with my bleach on it. Slowly, but it's melting. And I didn't put it up any higher than that because I didn't want it to scorch. Now, this is not enough. I'm going to go ahead and use my other cheese. I'm going to worry about the casserole later. But I don't want to use all of their beef. Overboard. Because I don't have egg in it when you take it. Y'all don't understand how good that already is. Oh my word, I'm gonna put a little more of this in there. What you say? Another 4 ounces. While it's hot. You wanna say hey to the camera? Y'all eating up all the blow pops? Mm-mm. Ooh, did they taste this?
Remember on
Tuesday? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, you could have made that stuff you made.
What?
The, that, whatever it was like a, it was with the noodles. It was kind of like a stew, whatever, and it had spinach in it. It was real good.
Oh, what I made
for it? Yeah, that stuff was good.
I got my meat browning.
We're going to get this together.
Y'all, 'cause I keep snacking. It's too frozen.
Add a little bit of water to it. Okay. Trying to get my cheese to melt. Real quick. Let that thing smell too. I use a lot of dishes, y'all, when I'm cooking.
Oh, Lord. Then we'll go overboard.
Now, in this bowl, I have some crabs from the other day. I have these crabs and then the crab juice. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add the gumbo seasoning. Hold on. I'm going to add some tomato paste. Excuse me for reaching over you. While I open this can, I got a candle from somewhere, a hand candle. With me when the thing is bent. So you would like to cover up something, huh? Where's
taking my butter knife when I need it. Hey, I used to have a little purple spatula somewhere. This is 6 ounces of tomato paste. I'm going to add some water. More water. That's gonna be good. Now, for my crab, I'm gonna break them open. Clean it. We need to take off the gills. Clean this middle out. Take your finger, just run it down it. Break it in half. Put it in the pot. Take the legs off. Throw those in there. Pull a little flap back. That's all we got. For y'all that don't know how to clean crabs, I'm going to show you right quick. So, here is the male crab, okay? That's the male. The male and the female, okay? Now, you're going to pop all the legs off, lift up this little flap like that. Pop it off. Then hold this part right here. Put a finger here, and then there's a little knob right here where you pop the claw off. Put your right thumb there, your left thumb on the top of the claw, like that, and pull it apart. Now, you are inside. Peel this part off at the bottom, and all of this in the middle, just take your finger and go down and scrape it out. A lot of people like to eat that, I don't. And right here are the gills. Right here. Pull them off. They're on each side. We call them the dead man. Why, I don't know. But that's what they call them. Put that in there. Next one. Legs. Pop the legs off. Which you can leave them on. That's the flap. This is the female. Pop it off. Position your thumb, top of the crab, which is right here. It's the little knob where the leg just came from. And pull it apart. Clean it. If you're nice, nasty, this is not for you. You don't mind getting your hands dirty. Now, when I say people used to eat that, see that orange? They love that. I don't eat that. So I clean it out. And this is what it looks like. Okay. Let's see what else I have in my bowl. Got some more legs. piece of potato from the other day. And I have another crab left. No, you ready? Okay. Okay. Clean it. Pop it. Put it in there.
And rest my hand.
I'm going to discard this. I'm going to take this out of the way in case I need some more juice. Clean up some of my mess. Put it back on the top. I'm gonna let that simmer. What I do with my bed. You have to bust up in a few minutes. This thing getting full of dishes. Now, macaroni and cheese. Finish mixing it up. Put my binder in there. I think my pan gonna be big enough. That pan not gonna, I don't think this pan gonna be big enough. It might. Still a potato. Potato butter. Got all my cheese in it. Oil. Now, keep my fork from sticking, I'm going to spray it with some canola oil.
Hold on, y'all.
Y'all know I'm not organized in the kitchen. I do this as I go, okay? Yes. Got that done. Get out of the way now for my cheek. Turn it up a little bit. Remember, I saved my oil. It's already flavored, seasoned. I am going to say it. Let that heat up. So, let me move all my stuff out. What would you do for a glass of water? Y'all, these potatoes are good. Try what you say. So, get my big daddy. Here's all my chicken that's been washed. I'm dump it in here. All I'm gonna season with is a little cayenne pepper. And salt. Ooh, I gotta sneeze off. That pepper got me, y'all. Yeah. Mix it up. Pull some of this water off. Salt in the flour. cayenne pepper.
Pan is truly covered with flour, okay? Testing the flour. Not hot enough yet. Turn it up just a little bit. Some more water. Now, at this point, I have, this is by Swanson, Louisiana Cajun flavor infused broth, okay? Simply combine with your favorite ingredients and for flavoring dishes. Broth infused with robust flavors of Cajun spices, green bell pepper, celery, onion, and garlic. You can make this yourself by boiling, but I saw it and I wanted to try it, and so I am going to add some of this in as well. I got it from Walmart, and this is about a cup that I had left. And it has recipes on the back. Gumbo with andouille sausage. Dried onion, two stalks of celery, green bell peppers, a carton of Swanson Cajun flavored infused broth, frozen okra, cooked chicken. I'm not adding chicken to this because I'm frying chicken. Flour and sausage and canola oil. Heat 2 tablespoons of oil in the saucepan over medium heat. Add sausage cooker to brown. Remove sausage and drain. Do not pour off drippings. Reduce heat to medium low. Stir in remaining oil, flour, and cook until mixture is dark brown. Stir in onion, celery, and peppers and cook 15 minutes. Stir in broth, okra, chicken, and sausage. Heat to a boil. Reduce heat to low and cook for 20 minutes. Then they have a Louisiana-style beans and rice recipe and a hearty jambalaya. And you can go to Swanson's, it's SwansonBroth.com. I'm going to save that off to the side. It's getting there. Not quite. Cheese and butter back. I can't stand when my scent gets in the dishes. I can't, y'all. I'm at 53 minutes, which is an hour. So I'll be back with part 3. Be back, y'all.